What up, what up? Welcome back to the channel where we mix fitness and music. So in this one, I'm gonna dive into a question that one of my subscribers actually sent out to me by a person named Generic IGN. And their question actually was, if I'm eating a diet consisting of beans, chicken, and veggies, is that okay to be done? And that was all the information that was given to me, kind of ended right there. Now, what I want to say to Generic IGN is I'm going to go ahead and try to help you out to the best of my ability, but there are a lot of pieces of information that are being left out. Some people will actually include beans, chicken, and veggies at one time throughout the day. If you're talking about a diet where you consistently eat these types of foods all throughout the day, that's okay, all right? And I say that's okay because it's all about what your body is gonna accept and take. I'll give you myself, for example, and maybe the case for most people. If you eat a diet that is containing the exact same foods all throughout the day, and you carry that on for days on end, you're gonna come to the conclusion and find that your body will desire variety, all right? Variety is key. Not only because the body craves different tastes, different flavors, but different. So not only does your body crave different tastes and different flavors, but along with you adding variety to your diet, you're also going to add different nutrients, vitamins, and minerals by eating different foods. So that's a big question that I would have for you after you've asked me your question. Are you going to consume these foods all throughout the day, and will these be the only foods you consume? What I'm going to do is I'm going to dive into some scenarios and situations that may be able to help you out, because again, I didn't get all of the necessary information that would really help me give you a spot on answer. I'm going to have to kind of dance around it just a little bit. So when we're looking at what foods are taken in throughout the day, again, and something that I've said in my previous videos, it's mainly geared towards your BMR, all right? Your BMR is going to give you the idea of how many calories you want to intake. You can decide on where those calories come from. So whether they be beans, whether they be veggies or chicken or a combination of all three, at the end of the day, what matters most is what is your goal, okay? Without me knowing your goal, it's very hard to give any guidance on what you should do. So we're gonna dance around different goals and how you would go about handling it if you were to consume beans, chicken, and veggies, let's say all throughout the day. I'll even cover once a day if that works too. So let's go ahead and cover all throughout the day, all right? So you're consuming beans, veggies, and chicken all throughout the day. Next thing we need to figure out, what is your goal? If your goal is to lose weight, if you are taking in these types of foods, what you need to consider is how many carbohydrates are contained within those beans. Beans usually pack a punch in the area of protein and in the area of carbs. Okay, very good substitute if you want to take rice out of the equation, because rice doesn't have many proteins in it. Choosing beans is usually a smarter choice because you get the combination of them both. When you choose rice, you mainly consume carbohydrates. When you choose beans, you get a little bit of carbs and a little bit of proteins, which could be more beneficial based on the goal you have at hand. If your goal is to lose weight, it doesn't matter if you consume these foods. If it's sustainable, then go ahead and knock it out. What you will find that makes the most sense is, based on whatever your goal is, the caloric amount that you need to target throughout the day is what's gonna get you closer to your goal. For example, if you wanna lose weight and you figured out that your BMR is 2,000 calories, then in order for you to lose that weight, you need to take in less than 2,000 calories throughout the day in order for your body to be in a deficit. If your body is in a deficit, regardless of if you had French fries and cheeseburgers, at the end of the day, if you're considered to be within a deficit where you've burned more calories than you have taken in, usually the result is weight loss, okay? So that is a great choice. I like the fact that you're actually choosing veggies. Veggies, A1, when it comes down to, building the body all around, focusing on the proper nutrients, vitamins, and minerals that come in, you'll benefit and gain a lot from actual vegetables. When it comes down to beans, I don't know what you have going on in your life, but if you live a life that's somewhat very active, okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would say, you know, you're right around about an 8. So maybe you're doing a lot of daily activities, maybe walking, jogging, doing some kind of exercise, taking kids to school, you know, maybe going out, doing laundry, things like that. Let's just say you're very active throughout the day. You need to make sure that your calories coming in is geared and based on the amount of activity that is being done. What you will find is that you can actually consume a little more calories based on how much activity is done. If your goal is to lose weight, you want to keep in mind that your amount of activity needs to outweigh the amount of calories coming in. So beans, veggies, and chicken is actually going to be something okay to do. The one thing I will stress is that when you're dealing with beans, okay, that's going to pack a punch in the area of carbohydrates. And when it comes down to losing weight, the one thing, the barrier you try to break through is that carbohydrate barrier. For example, if I consume 50 grams of carbs, the moment I go out to do any physical activity, those carbohydrates that have been consumed are usually what my body will rely on in order to get me through that workout or whatever activity I'm actually doing. So with that being said, you gotta keep focus and make sure that the type of carbohydrates that you take in are done accordingly to whatever it is you have going on. For example, if I'm gonna go out and work out, I don't mind a little bit of rice, I don't mind a little bit of bread, and especially beans packing a punch in the area of carbohydrates and protein, I definitely wouldn't mind that either, because I can immediately go in and start to work on my caloric burning process and get things kind of moving. Further into the evening, you'll find that beans may not be your best selection. And this is why I was asking, how often is this food actually coming in? If it is done once or twice throughout the day, that's fine. If you continuously consume beans, veggies, and chicken all throughout the day, let's say 3, 4, 5 meals all day, you're gonna find that as you drift closer into the evening, those beans are not going to work for you the same way they would if you were to only consume them in the morning if your goal is to lose weight. All right, I need you to follow me. We're talking about losing weight. And if carbohydrates are consumed closer, well into the evening time, it's going to be very hard in order to get it off or burn it or have your body burn through it while you're actually sleeping. So in the area of weight loss, you may not see much success. Now, if you're dealing with caloric maintenance, this could get a little tricky because again, I have to stress it, that as you consume carbohydrates leading up into the evening hours, usually it's when your body starts winding down, you're gonna find that it's harder for your body to, you know, burn through that many calories that late at night because you're really not doing much activity, okay? So thinking about maintaining your weight, this diet is something that you could consider, but you're gonna have to tweak your amounts as you get closer into the evening. So you can still have beans. I just would make sure the amount of beans that was consumed in the morning, whether it be a cup, 2 cups, whatever that amount is, as you get closer to the evening slot, if this is your only choice of food you're gonna decide to consume, you're gonna make sure that as you get closer into the evening, you reduce the amount of beans you're taking in. And I stress beans, okay? When you're looking at things like veggies are a little different. Yes, vegetables usually have carbohydrates contained, but it's usually not as much as beans. With that being said, you know that you can actually eat a good bit of vegetables, fill yourself up, but at the end of the day, you didn't really consume that many calories. It's more so about volume and tricking your body into thinking that you're full, but you're actually not. So you consume this big plate of veggies after it's all consumed, down and ready to be digested. You're now in a position where the volume is taking control of your level of hunger. So even though you consume this big plate of veggies, you end up only packing in 200 calories, okay? The volume will take control and make you feel full. So you've eaten this big plate, you feel full, but at the end of the day, you know it's only 200 calories, very similar to how salads work, okay? Now, if you're talking about weight gain, if you're trying to build muscle, not really minding, hey, if I pack on a little bit of fat here, a little bit of fat there, doesn't really matter as long as I'm on track to building muscle. This will be okay. All right, I don't really have to say much on anything. You can consume the beans, the veggies, and the chicken all throughout the day, 4, 5, 6 times a day in all the various amounts that you would like to actually have. And I'm saying that because you now are in a position where we're disregarding how much fat you're gonna actually pack on. If you wanna consider packing on muscle and tweaking that fat level as low as it can possibly go, that'll all come in with the caloric amounts. So still feel free to consume those three foods all throughout the day, but you will know and understand that consuming less beans and all of that as you progress into the evening, but still making sure that it's contained in the diet, will lead to you building muscle and possibly reducing as much fat that could possibly be stored on. The last thing you want to do is actually get out there and just do beans, rice, veggies all throughout the day, not considering any goals, what the end result's going to be, and you know, not really caring about what happens next. It's not the aim and not the focus you want to go for. You want to make sure you lay out your three goals, consider what you want to do, what are you on track to do, and you want to lay out this game plan for a few weeks on the time span, on the range. So with that being said, hopefully I answered your question. I tried to the best of my ability. I tried to dance around it and come from all the different angles. How would you approach it if you were trying to lose weight, maintain your weight? And also, how would you approach it if you were trying to gain weight? And gain weight means building muscle. All right. Generic IGN, hit me with another question if need be. If you do have more details that you want to fill me in on about this one, feel free to do so. At my earliest convenience, I will get back to you and answer your question. That's it for the video. I'm gonna go ahead and get up off this one. Y'all know what it is, conservative guy. I'm out.